Thank you for taking the time out of your special schedule to attend this conference. The purpose of this conference is to introduce frontline experts from Zhejiang Province to Wuhan to fight the epidemic to the frontline experts in Mexico. Thus, the Chinese experts can share the rich experience accumulated during the epidemic, strengthening professional discussion. No matter how small or stupendous the impact of this conference will be, we will want to do every effort to help our global to overcome this epidemic together. This conference is initiated by Hangzhou Association for Science and Technology, Jack Ma Foundation, Alibaba Foundation. Of course, the participate of every expert is the most important. We are in Hangzhou Red Cross Hospital now. Our experts today are all from this hospital, and our Mexican experts are from over 6 different states, different institutions, hospitals. Again, thank you for attending our conference. So first, let's welcome our Dr. Xu, the director of Hangzhou Red Cross Hospital, to give us a short speech.
Hello, 大家好，我是杭州市红十字会医院的徐凯。 首先我简单的介绍一下我们医院，我们医院有90年历史的一家医院， 那么也是在医疗领域里边对中西结合有这个显著标志的一家医院。那么在这次新冠肺炎的这个疫情当中，我们也做一些工作，对预防也好，治疗也好，也出了几个中西结合的这个协定的处方。 那当然，我们也有不少同志在武汉的一线，对疫情防治工作也做了一些卓有成效的一些工作。那么，我们也非常愿意把这些工作的成绩以及我们的经验与大家共同分享。我相信我的伙伴们会把这些工作的碰到的一些问题以及解决的一些方法跟大家来今天这么个 比较好的机会当中做个非常好的分享，我简单的就介绍这些，谢谢。
Hello everyone. integrated with Western medicine, and during the epidemic of the coronavirus, we have done a lot of work on the prevention and the treatment of the COVID-19, and we have sent a medical team to the front line in Hubei to do the medical work. And we would like to share our experience to all of you. And I believe our companion will like to share their experience to all the peoples and to help you to resolve the problems. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And then our interpreter for today, Dr. Chen, will also introduce us the experts here. We will also send the name list to our group chat at the same time.
Yeah, first, I would like to introduce all the experts here, presented here. And first will be Professor Deng. He is the vice president of our hospital, and he also is the lead of the medical team we sent to Wuhan. And to Wuhan Tongji Hospital, and he also ran a COVID-19 ward, and
Yeah.
Okay, and another expert here is Professor Li Zhihui. He also is a chief of intensive unit of our hospital, and he also have been to Wuhan to run a COVID-19 ward. And and another expert is Professor He Fei. He is the chief of our respiratory disease department. And the other is two nurses. One is Mr. Gui Tao, and the other is Miss Zhen Jiandi. She is the head nurse of endocrinology department, and the other one is Dr. Zhao Lan. She is the head of our hospital infectious control department, and the other one is Professor Li Zhao Dong. He's the director of our clinical laboratory, and the last one is Professor Qiu Xiaowei. He's the director of our radiology department.
Okay, thank you very much. And then I'll introduce the agenda for today's conference. The agenda for today has two parts. First, our experts are going to answer some questions which we had already collected from some Mexican doctors before. Then the whole process will be 1 hour. Second, we will have the question and answer session, which will also be 1 hour. In order to make this session work orderly, we will start the session. The one who wants to ask the question, please send one to our group chat, and we will give the chance of asking the questions according to the order that you guys sent into the group. And our colleague will send a one to the group chat to send a sample. Okay, everyone can see that in the group chat, Jane has already called one. And when our second session started, I'll say, okay, doctors, please send one to the group chat, and you guys send the one. And the order for you guys to ask the question will be the order of the one you send. Okay? And don't worry if you do not get a chance to ask during this conference for today, because we can still communicate in this group chat after the conference. Feel free to message us. Our doctor will spare no effort to help. Okay, then let's move to our first session. The topic of every doctor's presentation are included in the name list we just sent into the group. You can check them there. And first, let's welcome Dr. Deng to share some experience about the preparation for the hospital.
Hey, 你好。我接收到的问题是，如何快速为医院做好准备，使之更有效率。和第二个问题是，尤其是吸氧和床位分配。按照我们中国的经验和武汉的经验，如果说让一家医院行之有效的把新冠肺炎进行集中收治，应收尽收和集中管理，那么你主要从几个方面。第一个，医院建设就是硬件设施的建设，院感优先，一定要是院保证院感也要优先。第二个，流程要合理，要有一定的规范和制度。第三个就是一定要发布，新冠肺炎救治的指南。 这是个硬件保障。第二个，软件的集中，软件集中就是医护人员，医护人员一定要集中进行集中培训、集中的演练，适应这种新的流程和新的工作方式。第三大块一定要做好后勤保障，后勤保障包括了医护的防护和病人的防护，这是必须要做到的。这是三大块的，一定要把这三大块做到以后，对于病人来说一定是要应收尽收，定点收治和集中管理。在集中管理的情况下，新冠的病人死亡率是很低的啊，这是一个关于硬件设施。第二，关于吸氧，吸氧来说，一定要把这吸氧的压力，因为我们在突然的一下子病人大量的进去以后，发现氧气的压力会不够，所以我们建议还是用钢瓶吸氧。管道吸氧的压力可能会瞬间，如果30台呼吸机同时使用的情况下，氧气的压力会很低，达不到标准，但达不到要求，所以用钢瓶吸氧啊。这是一个关于床单位来说，我们严格的来说，床单位没有严格的要求，但是有一点，就是有确诊病人和疑似病人一定要分开管理。当然，如果有负压病房，那是非常理想的。啊，如果在短期内见不到，只是把进行良好的通风，对于这个病房就可以了，对于床单位就可以了。啊，我回答的问题就是这些。好，谢谢。
Professor Deng will answer question about how to quickly prepare for the hospital and to make it more efficient. And for this question, we have experience from Wuhan, and the point is we have to attend all the patients and we have to treat all the patients. And first is the hardware equipment should be insured in our hospital, and the most important is the control of hospital infection. And we have to schedule a rational flow to do the medical work. And we have also have to set up some administration rules. And for all the health workers, we have to do the training about all the infection control policies. And For patients, we have to let all the patients to be to wear the mask to protect them, and also we have to to be caution of the protection between them, the doctors and the nurse, and so if we have done all the things about attend all the patients and treat all the patients, and we gather them, all the patients together to treat them, the mortality will be very low. About the oxygen, the oxygen take in hospital, in case there will be a lot of ventilator used at the same time, so the pressure of the oxygen will be not sufficient. So we the central supply of the oxygen is not enough. We suggest we have to prepare some oxygen cylinder for the oxygen supply, and for all the bed distribution, it is very important to divide all the suspect patients and confirm the patients. And if we can prepare some negative pressure ward, will be better. But if we don't have that condition and we don't have that ward, a well-ventilated ward will be better.